Hello everyone, welcome back to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 221 to 240. This is the part 13th of top 400 MCQ of the criminal procedure. Before starting this video, please, if you are like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel and click on bell icon for further notification. Now, question number 221. The cognizance of offense of defamation under chapter 21 of IPC. The first important thing is here, chapter 21 of IPC provided the information about the defamation, the offense of defamation. So in chapter 21, it is started from 499 to 502. After that, this section, the criminal intimidation is different offense, but here defamation is provided under section 499 to 502. So according to, in this question, option A here. So first of all, there is a cognizance of offense of defamation under chapter 21 of IPC can be taken. So who take the cognizance? And on the basis of first option here, on a police report, option B here, on a complaint made by aggrieved person or party, option C, suo motu, option D, all of the above. So according to section 199 CRPC subsection 1, no magistrate take cognizance except the written complaint by the aggrieved person. So there must be a written complaint, or which person is institute such complaint? Only aggrieved person or party. So in this question, answer is here option B, the complaint made by an aggrieved person. Now question number 222, whether a magistrate take a cognizance of offense on complaint made to him and considered before the issue of process to accuse that the matter should be investigated, such investigation can be under. In this question, important point is here, magistrate takes cognizance. If magistrate not take cognizance, he has power to instruct the investigation under section 156. Either this option or this. If the police has submitting their report and request for further investigation, so magistrate allow him for further investigation. So further investigation in there. And section 190 is provided that taking cognizance of magistrate of offense. So all these options are wrong here according to this question, because magistrate take cognizance. So last option is here 202, where the magistrate take cognizance and of a offense of complaint made to him and consider before issue process, he want to find out. Their important point is, now magistrate is not satisfied with the complaint, he want to find out the reality of the complaint. So he has power to postpone. First important, according to section 200, he has power to postpone. Postponement of issue process. Which thing is postponed here? Issue process. Issue process is postponed by the magistrate, and he find out whether there is a sufficient ground. So if he has or he has not, so during the foundation of finding these grounds, he has power to conduct inquiry. So first important point here, inquiry conduct by who? Conduct inquiry, same magistrate. Magistrate in conduct inquiry himself. Magistrate conduct inquiry himself, and if magistrate is satisfied and with inquiry, so in the after that he may sue process or dismissal of the complaint. But the another option is, if magistrate is very busy and he is not want to conduct inquiry, he instruct the investigation to the police officer. So next point here, इन्वेस्टिगेशन बाय पुलिस ऑफिसर और अदर पर्सन. अदर पर्सन ऑल्सो कंडक्ट हियर इन्वेस्टिगेशन. देर इज नो नेसेसरी सच इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज कंडक्टेड बाय पुलिस ओनली. इफ मजिस्ट्रेट थिंक फिट एनी अदर पर्सन हु इज एबल टू कंडक्ट सच इन्वेस्टिगेशन मजिस्ट्रेट इंस्ट्रक्ट हिम. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन दीज पॉइंट्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो नाउ ऑप्शन डी इज करेक्ट हियर 202. Now come to the question number 223. On the receipt of complaint before ordering investigation by the police under section 153 subsection 3 of CRPC, the magistrate has to see that option A, the complaint discloses a cognizable offence travelled by magistrate. Cognizable offence travelled by magistrate. Option B, complaint discloses cognizable offence exclusively travel by session court. Option C, the complaint discloses the cognizable offense irrespective of whether the same is traveled by magistrate or exclusively travel by session court. A court of session here. Option D, the complaint discloses cognizable offense only by magistrate, not exclusively travel by court of session, as it is for a magistrate to inquire himself into offense exclusively travel by the court of session. So now I again read here question here. The receipt of complaint before ordering investigation by police under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC, magistrate has to see that. Now option C is correct here. The complaint discloses the cognizable offense. There is irrespective. Which thing is irrespective? Either such offense is travelled by magistrate or exclusively travelled by session court. So it is not a matter. So complaint is discloses the cognizable offense. Now option C is correct here. Question number 224. In complaint discloses a commission of offence travelled by magistrate. Option A, it is necessary to examine a complainant and all the other witness on oath. Option B, it is not necessary. First here necessary and second here not necessary to examine the complainant and all other witnesses. Option C, it is necessary to examine the complainant on oath and it is not necessary to examine all other witnesses. Option D, both A and B. So in this question is here, complaint discloses the commission of offense traveled by magistrate. So option C is correct here. It is necessary to examine a complainant on oath and it is not necessary to examine all the other witnesses. Now question number 225. The recording of pre-summoning evidence may be dispensed with under section 200 of CRPC if the complaint is supported by the affidavit of complainant. Option B, if the complaint is made in writing by a public servant in the discharge of his official duty. Option C, both A and B are correct. Option D, only A is correct but B are wrong. Yeah, incorrect here. So answer B is correct. Recording of the pre-summoning evidence may be a dispense with the under section 200 of CRPC if the complaint is made writing by the public servant in the discharge of his official duty. Now question number 226. Once the magistrate has proceeded with the examination of a complainant or decided to record the statement of the complainant on the oath. So the statement of the complainant's witness on the oath and complainant is examination on the oath. The police cannot be directed to investigate under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC. Option B, the police can still be directed to investigate under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC. Option C, police may or may not be directed under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC depending on the fact and circumstance of the case. And now option D, both B and C. So here answer is police cannot be directed to investigate under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC, because after the taking cognizance, the magistrate in for investigation or inquiry under section 202, not 156 subsection 3. Now question number 227. On a complaint for offense tribal by a magistrate, after the recording of the statement of complainant and witnesses, if any on oath, the police can be directed to investigate under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC. The police can be directed to investigate under section 202 of CRPC. Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. So answer is here clear, under section 202 of CRPC. Now question number 228. On a complaint for offense tribal by a court of session, after recording of the statement of complainant and the witnesses on oath, the police can be directed to investigate under section 156 subsection 3 of CRPC. The police can be directed to investigate under section 202 of CRPC. Option C, police cannot be directed to investigate at all, and the magistrate himself has to conduct an inquiry. Option D, both A and B. So in this question, I again show here question. The complaint for us, the offense traveled by session court. First important point is session court. And after recording of the statement of the complainant and witness on oath. So this is very important here, because traveled by session court here. So it is here, answer is option C. The police cannot be directed to investigate at all. The magistrate himself has to conduct inquiry here. So option C is correct here. Now question number 229. The direction to the police to investigate under section 202 can be given without examining the complainant on oath, cannot be given without examining the complainant on oath. Option C here, can be given before or after the examining the complainant on oath. Option D, both A and C. So here answer is option B, cannot be given without examination the complainant on oath. After examining the complainant on the oath or his witness, the magistrate direct the police to investigate under section 202, and magistrate also having a power to conduct inquiry himself in this section. So answer is here B. Now question number 230. In complainant disclosing the commission of offense exclusively traveled by court of session, it is necessary that the complainant and some of the witness to examine on oath. Option D, B here, it is necessary to examine the complainant on oath and no witness need to be examined on oath. Option C, it is necessary to examine the complainant and all the witnesses of complainant on oath. Option D, either A or B. So here answer is option C. It is necessary to examine the complainant and all the witness of complainant on oath. Now question number 331. The filing the list of witness by a complainant before issuing of summon or warrant to the accused under section 204 of CRPC, it is mandatory. Option B is discretionary, directory. Option B here directory. Option C neither mandatory nor directory. Option D here either mandatory or directory. So in this question answer is here it is mandatory, because section 202-204 here using the word shall be submitted. So shall word submitted, which thing is submitted here? The list of witnesses before issue process. Issue processes. So there must be submitted the list of witness before issuing process. So such provision is mandatory provision according to section 204. So if magistrate is issuing process under section 204, there is a necessary to submitting the list of witness. Now question number 232. If the complainant fail to file the list of witnesses before issuing of summon or warrant, this thing issuing of summon and warrant is also called the issue process, to the accused. Option A here same cannot be filed thereafter. Option B same can be filed at any time thereafter without the permission of the court. Option C same can be filed at any time thereafter only with the permission of court. Option D either A or B. So here answer is option C. Same can be filed at any time thereafter only the permission of the court. So first of all the examination of complainant is complete here, and now now the complainant filing the list of the witnesses. So if he added the witnesses, so such list can be filed at any time thereafter the permission of the court. So option C is correct here. Now question number 233. The special summon under section 206 of CRPC can be issued by magistrate only, by court of session, by magistrate as well as court of session. Option D here by court of high court, by high court. So answer is here option A, only by magistrate. So the section 206 is provided that the special summon, in which case of special summon? Petty case. So petty case special summon. So petty offenses the magistrate issues the special summon according to section 206. So answer is here option A. Now question number 234. A case can be committed to the court of session by magistrate. Option A under section 209 of CRPC. Option B under section 323 of CRPC. Option C under section 324 of CRPC. Option D here both A and B above. So it is clear here option both A and B, because the committal magistrate, there are a committal provision of the committal magistrate. So it is provided in section 209, and such this section is read with section 323. So The answer of this question is option D. Now again I shows here question here. The case to be committed, this is committed to the court of session by magistrate. It is committal magistrate here. So the provision I again show here 209 read with 323. Now question number 235. Under section 209, the CRPC, the case can be committed to the court of session if the offense is exclusively trialed by the court of session, if the magistrate think that the case ought to be trialed by the court of session. Option C, both A and B, and option D, only B, not A. So here answer is, according to section 209, answer is the if the offense is exclusively trialed by the court of session. So option A is correct here, and this option is available in section 323. The magistrate think that the case ought to be trialed by the court of session. Here magistrate think that here, and in this section 209, exclusively trialed by magistrate, know that this offense is exclusively trialed by the court of session, and this provision is provided under section 209. But if the magistrate think that this case is ought to be trialed by the court of session, in such case the section is applicable 323. Now question number 236. Under section 323 of CRPC provides for committal of case to the court of session. Option A, which discloses the commission of offense exclusively trialed by the court of session. Option B, which magistrate think ought to be trialed by the court of session. Option C, both A and B, and option D, only A, not B. So it is clear here, option B is correct, in which the magistrate think ought to be tried by the court of session. Now question number 237. Section 210 of CRPC provides for the stay of police investigation. Option B, stay of proceeding in complaint case. Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. So it is clear here, option B, stay on proceeding in complaint case. This is the doctrine of merger. This is where there are institution of a complaint case and already proceeding under the police report, and if the police report and complaint case are related to a same offense, the magistrate merger this complaint into the police report. So this is called, and according to section 210 subsection 2, it is called the doctrine of merger. So it is doctrine of merger. So it is always treated as the police report, not complaint case. If the police report and complaint case related to a same offense, the finally treated as police report, not complaint. So, and stay the proceeding in complaint case. So option B is correct here. Now question number 238. Section 210 of CRPC can be invoked when there is a complaint and police also investigating the matter. When there is a complaint case but no police investigation in process. Is there a complaint case and the police has already completed the investigation and file a final report? Option D, all of the above. So answer is here option A. When there is a complaint case and police is also investigating the matter. Now question number 239. In the case of merger, so the complaint case become the police report, police case. So, and of the complaint with the police report of the procedure to be followed for the trial shall be of a complaint case, shall be of a case instituted on the police report, shall be of both as per a convenience during the trial. Option D, shall be the one as directed by the magistrate. I already clarified this provision of this section, so it is clear here. Option B, shall be of the institute on the police report. Now, final question of this video, question number 240. Before issuing the process against the accused in complaint case, the accused has right to participate in the proceeding. The accused has no right here, right, and here no right to participate in the proceeding. The accused has a right to watch the proceeding. Option D here, both B and C. So before issuing the process against the accused in complaint case, look at this, is very important here, complaint case. So before issuing the process, the magistrate has not issues the summon or warrant to the accused. So how the accused note that any complaint against him? So according to this question, answer is B here, correct. The accused has no right to participate in the proceeding. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you.